Hi, I'm Summer from Mailchimp. Thanks for joining me. So in this video, I'll show you how Mailchimp signup forms can help you grow and organize your audience. First, I'll explain what we mean by signup forms here at Mailchimp. Then I'll give you an overview of the variety of our different form types and the options you have when creating each. Before we go any further, I want to mention that in order to use some of our forms, you'll need to have a website that's connected to Mailchimp. To learn how to do that, visit the domains page or check out our help center. Okay, so in Mailchimp, signup forms are used for collecting customer information, even though those customers may not have purchased a product or service from you yet. For example, you can put a signup form on your website asking for customer information in exchange for a discount or to receive a free product. Signup forms help potential customers start building a relationship with the brand. Forms can also be used to better understand customer intent and help you start tagging and segmenting your audience. In short, they're a powerful way to extend the reach of your email marketing. Mailchimp offers a variety of different signup form templates depending on your goals and the different types of information you want to collect. Ready to dive in? Okay, let's do it. So let's sign into Mailchimp to get started. In this sidebar, I'll click Forms. You'll see the pop-up forms overview and the page as the current default. Now, when you create a pop-up in Mailchimp, your forms will be highly customizable, mobile-friendly, and completely free. And they don't require any coding on your part to get started. Pop-up forms are great to generate leads, share a promo code, drive traffic to specific pages on your website, boost engagement, and of course, collect more contacts. Now, after setting a goal for your form, you'll select customizable pre-built templates that offer incentives to get visitors to sign up. You can create as many pop-up forms as needed per audience and tailor them to suit your marketing needs. So to help you get started, we have tutorials available in our Help Center and YouTube channel. Now we'll move on to other forms and select Embedded Form. These are the HTML forms Mailchimp can create for you, and you can paste the code directly into your website. Now, if you've built a site outside of Mailchimp, this could be a good form for you to use. Now, after you clicked Embedded Forms, you'll enter the form name. Okay, audience, and click Continue to Builder. All right, so here you'll see options for customizing form fields, settings, tags, and Mailchimp referral badge. So let's take a look at form fields. If the toggle is on, the field will be visible. And then you can also customize the display name of each field and choose which fields are required. Settings is where you adjust your form's title, okay? Formatting and tags are internal labels that help you organize your contacts. For example, if a contact has just signed up for your audience, you can tag them as a new customer. Your customers won't see these tags, so choose whatever is most helpful to you in marketing. When you toggle on the referral badge, you'll earn credits when someone clicks on your badge and then signs up for a paid Mailchimp plan. All right, now we've covered the main options for embedded forms. Once you've finished editing, click Continue. And then your form is ready. Oh, okay. So all that's left is to click Copy Code. And then just paste it into your website to share that form to your web visitors. All right, let's move on. Let's talk about our next form type, sign up landing page. Landing pages are standalone web pages that your contacts land on when they click a shared link. Marketers often use these pages to achieve short-term goals, like promoting a limited time offer. In my case, I want to use a landing page to capture leads. So let's click Other Forms, then Create New Form, and then Sign Up Landing Page. We'll name our landing page and then click Continue to Builder. This will prompt us to select a template for the landing page. Since my goal is to capture more leads, I'll select the lead generation template and add my content. Now, some templates are specifically designed to collect subscribers or promote products, but you can add a sign-up form content block or product block to any layout. Okay, so to learn how to design and publish your sign-up landing page, check out our Help Center. From the Forms tab, let's click Other Forms, and then scroll down to Form Builder. All right, this allows you to build a sign-up page that can be hosted on a provided URL or edit some existing forms that come with your MailChimp account, like an email unsubscribe form to include in your emails. Let's start by selecting a form type in the dropdown at the top labeled Forms in Response Emails. All right, so we have three main tabs on the Form Builder. They are Build It, Design It, and Translate It. The Build It tab is where you'll add structure and content to your sign-up form and responses. Use the Build It tab of the Form Builder to add or remove audience fields and change field settings. Now, deleting a field erases all contact data collected from that field. So, if you deleted the first name field, you would lose the first names of anyone who submitted that data through your form. Instead of deleting fields, we recommend hiding them. To do this, click on a field and then in Field Settings. Set field visibility to hidden. Next, let's have a look at the tab for design. The Design It tab is where you'll edit the style, color, font, and graphics of your signup form and response emails. You can also edit the page and body layout for your signup form and response emails here. In design changes you make here, like changing your background color or font, you will be inherited by all of your other forms that live in this area. This helps build brand consistency for all the pages your subscribers will interact with, and it saves you some time. Moving on to our last tab, let's click Translate It. Here is where you can turn on auto translate. So set your default language, change text direction, and customize the form text for your default language. Keep in mind that form field labels will have to be manually translated in the audience settings. These are the labels like email address that you see in the Build It tab. Now, if you need something that isn't offered by a visual form designer, we do have an advanced mode. Now, this is a paid feature, so check the details of your marketing plan. And for more on our form builder, take a look at the resources linked in the description. After you've built your form, you can grab the URL link and share it. There's also an option to download a QR code if you want to share your form at a physical location. Additionally, I want to mention our form integrations. Basically, these are add-ons that help you collect signups on social sites, blogs, or e-commerce and marketing platforms. From the Forms tab, go ahead and click Other Forms. Now scroll down to Form Integrations. All right, so here's an example of form integration. Let's say you want to connect to Squarespace 6 form to your MailChimp list. The structure of that external form will be mirrored to your MailChimp list data configuration. As you build the form, each Squarespace form field is automatically mapped to an equivalent MailChimp list field. When a contact submits a form, they'll then be captured into MailChimp as a list subscriber. This integration makes it easy for Squarespace users to add MailChimp newsletter signup forms to their sites. Okay, I've covered our main signup form options. If these aren't fully tailored to your needs, you can customize signup forms using code, then pass subscriber data back to the MailChimp through our API. This is an advanced technical feature. So work with your developer or consider hiring a MailChimp expert. Now this just about wraps up our video. Thanks for hanging in there. Remember, signup forms aren't just about collecting email addresses or phone numbers. In reality, they are the start of an ongoing conversation with your customers. Using forms to grow your audience can help you organize your contacts based on their interests and needs. And if you know who your contacts are, you can create more engaging content to reach the right people with the right message. I'm so excited for you to give signup forms a try. And then as a next step, try building a segment to target customers based on their form data. And if you have more questions about forms, please visit MailChimp.com/help.